Thousands of people, including religious leaders, have today flocked to Igweng in Muchuini sub-county Kitugumu district to commemorate the 47th anniversary of Janan Luomo Day. On this day, Ugandans honor the legacy of faith and courage that was exhibited by the late Bishop Janan Luomo, who was murdered in cold blood by the late President Idi Amin.
We have a choice to serve the Almighty God, but not use Satan.
Madi and West Nile dioceses led the celebrations. Religious leaders described the late Archbishop Janan Luomo as a great servant of God who served unconditionally, adding that he will be greatly remembered for his good deeds and the faithful should emulate him.
The man we are celebrating today,
Janan Luomo, he
stood by his faith. He was not shaken.
The Archbishop of the Church of Uganda, Dr. Stephen Kazimba Mgalu, prayed for the country to overcome all the evils of corruption, murder, among others.
And we continue to pray that you render the devil powerless. And you take the devil as a captive.
Receive the power of God. Receive your healing in the name of Jesus.
The Minister of Internal Affairs, Jeno Kahindo Tafire, gave a brief history of how the late was murdered in cold blood by the ruthless leader in power by then, something which will forever be condemned. It's at this point that he warned politicians against always making reckless statements aimed at dividing people.
You could see from the way those in power were talking that the murder was inevitable. Anybody saying it was an accident is wrong. The mens rea was ominous.
He challenged Ugandans to be strong and to build a prosperous country which is not based on religious and tribalistic wars.
By we Ugandans celebrating the death of Janan Luomo and not questioning whether it was worthy for him to die. Why? Why did he have to die? This is the problem I have with some of my friends in the opposition. They say they're exercising the right to speak, but then they bring stones. So I say, freedom of expression is legitimate and legal, but rioting is illegitimate and a crime.
I encourage Ugandans to speak.
The Chief Justice, Alphonse Owinyi Dolo, who represented President Yoweri Kaguta Museveni at the function, told the public to stop mourning the brutal murder of the late Archbishop, but rather focus on his purpose on earth, which he served.
The war cry is to confront this monster of devastation, which manifests itself in our people doing things which me, old enough to have seen this society before the war, before Idi Amin, I'm ashamed.
The Chief Justice also called for peace building, asking people of Kitugum to forgive the West Nile people for the act which was done by the late Amin.
Primary responsibility is going to lie with us. Otherwise, we will continue to live in the pretense, in the lie, in the falsehood that we are all going together as Uganda, in a peaceful Uganda. This place is not. For over 30 years now, it has known no peace.
He further tasked people of Kitugum to ensure fundamental recovery of their area through fighting poverty and engaging in social revival.
Archbishop Luomo was a leading figure in the criticism of the excesses of the Idi Amin regime. We are gathered here to remember and celebrate the legacy of a man who did not relent on what he believed was right, and he ended up paying the ultimate price.
Report compiled by Jaliat Namuwaya for the news.